Welcome to the third part of this video series. In this part of the video, we are going to correct our some mistakes which we did earlier without means the mistakes which we did unknowingly earlier. So we are going to correct those mistakes, and one of those mistakes is the first one is the design part. Regarding the design part, the design part which is surrounding the glass of the bottle, if you are able to see the reference which is provided in the description, the design is intersecting with the glass part. So I am turning on the radial symmetry count. First I have to select the design part, then I have to turn on the radial symmetry count, which is 6. If you have watched the other videos, you might have got the point that I am using the 6 as a radial count. So as you can see, I am moving this design part a bit outside from the surface of the glass. Means if you are watching the concept, if you see the concept image, you will find out that this design part is surrounding the glass, not like it's intersecting with the glass. So I'm turning on the transparent button, which is here, and as you can see, if by turning on that button, I can easily rotate it and sculpt and just move the part from the inside also. So this is how I am just shaping it, because when I will be applying the shaders, then I will be rendering this thing in the future videos, and you will see that if those parts are intersecting, they will not look that good. So why not correct those things in the earlier stage? So I thought I should make this video for you guys, that sometimes it doesn't matter that if you have done something wrong, you can't correct it. You can always correct it. You just have to put your mind into it that you have to correct those things. Then just go for it, and you can correct those mistakes. Means mistakes are not permanent until you want them to be like that. You can change them. I haven't removed this section of the video, but I thought you should know that mistakes can happen with anyone. So you can see by turning on the ghost and transparent button, which are over here, you can easily move the mesh from the inside. Means if it is intersecting with something, that part will easily get excluded, and you can sculpt it. Then I am using trim dynamic brush for similarly like the detailing video. I am just creasing here and there a little bit. And you can select the subtool by directly holding Alt key on the keyboard and just directly clicking on the subtool. Then I'm using slash brush for just applying some cuts, some simple cuts. Then next, similarly, I'm creating a mask. Then I will be removing the mask by holding Ctrl and Alt, then drag, and I will get this thing. Then I will tap on the canvas by holding Ctrl key, and I will press W for the gizmo. Then I will click that pointer icon, then I am rotating it with Alt, holding Alt and Shift key. Then I am moving it above means I'm moving it above, because later on I realized that this part is a little higher in the concept image, so I just thought of correcting it now. Then I will reapply the Dynamesh. Then I will smooth out the edge, means I will smooth out the section. By clicking X, you can directly turn on the symmetry, and it will turn on as a default thing. Means if you have selected radial symmetry for your settings, then it will be automatically turned on when you press X. And if you don't want radial symmetry at that time, you can just go to the transform menu and you can turn on the radial symmetry. And you can see I am using trim dynamic brush and just creasing out some shapes, which will make it look good, and we will move on to the shading and texturing and rendering part. You can see I'm just shaping it slowly, because this is important. Small strokes are always important for making your big artwork beautiful. And now I have appended a sphere, and that sphere part is because I am reducing the size of it. And now I have to flatten the surface of the part, so I have just gone to the setting option. Then by there I have chosen the flatten option. Then I am just accepting it. So this part is the water surface, or the water or the poison surface or the liquid surface inside the glass part. And now I'm again appending a sphere for the bubbles on the surface of water. You will not be able to see this thing right now, but when I will be shading it and I will be applying the shaders, means I will apply the glass shader on the bottle, then after that I will apply the liquid shader for the inside part, then you will see that these small things will make the artwork look good. And I have appended the sphere for the one bubble. Then I have copied it by control and dragging again, means holding control and by dragging I can get the bubbles. If you have any doubt or any questions regarding this video, you can let me know in the comment section. I will definitely reply you. We will carry on the things in the next part. So stay tuned and keep watching the videos.